Today on Victory Videos, the artist,
the mother,
the humanitarian,
Amy Grant.
Stay tuned.
Look, Dave.
It's the Ohio River, Lavila.
Isn't it beautiful?
And there's Amy Grant down there.
No. Later on in the show.
That's right. How you doing? I'm Dave Dobbins.
And I'm Lavila Craft.
Or I could be Lavila Craft and you could be.
We did that once before.
That's right.
Been done.
Thanks for joining us. We're going to take a look at the profile on Amy Grant today.
Oh, yeah. She's taking a little bit of time off.
That's right.
But we've still had her around plenty because she's everywhere.
All over the radio
still from her last release. But now she's got a new one.
That's right. And we're going to take a look at a profile on Amy Grant, what she's up to, what she's been up to, and kind of a different look at Amy this time.
As the humanitarian, she's the artist. A woman of many hats.
And the mother, that's right.
Yeah.
So let's get started. Right off, we're going to start with Greg Long and Margaret Becker, and How Long, followed by
Brian Duncan.
And Traces of Heaven. Bug on my head.
Bug on your head.
Check it out.
Go away.
Some people talk about forever, like it's a time that never comes. Hey, but just like days we thought would last, time goes by so fast. Tomorrow's come and gone.
Our lives are treasure that we're given. Every hour is ours to spend, but every moment that we waste can never be replaced. It never comes again.
We get so caught up in the future.
Oh, yeah.
And we don't take the time to live.
You're watching Victory Videos. Coming up next, Amy Grant and her new release, House of Love.
It may not look like it, but you're watching the future of the Earth pass by. Because many of these products are made from materials you've been recycling. But to keep recycling working, you need to buy products that say, made from recycled materials. For all those next in line, it would mean the world to them.
In a life-threatening emergency, you should know what to do. Say a loved one exhibits unusual symptoms. The first thing to do is...
Clear!
No. The first thing to
do... Oh! Tourniquet!
No! The first thing you do is pick up the phone and dial your emergency number.
Call 911 first.
Right.
How about mouth to mouth?
I don't think so. Hmm. To learn more about life-saving techniques, contact your Red Cross.
Hey, Cincinnati, this is Steve Taylor in Kathmandu, and you're watching Victory Videos.
Excuse me, do you wear your safety belt?
Why, no, I don't wear my safety belt.
Thank you.
You could learn a lot from a dummy. Buckle your safety belt.
And that was Brian Duncan, Traces of Heaven.
Of Heaven.
There's a guy that's really done a lot for Christian music over the years, LaVilla.
Yeah, he really has.
And we're back. Back
hi.
At the edge of the Ohio, the mighty Ohio. We're taking a close look at Amy Grant as we're profiling what she's been up to. Now, we said at the beginning of this program, the humanitarian.
Oh, boy, she's been involved in one of the neatest programs, Habitat for Humanity.
Mm-hmm.
Isn't that the name of it?
Mm-hmm.
And these people pick a person, I don't know how they do it, but they build homes for mm-hmm. the people who need them the most.
You kind of get a chance to mm-hmm. see in this profile, the profile on this program, Amy and what she does besides being just a Christian artist.
Right.
How she is busy as a mother, she's busy as an artist, but also she's busy in reaching out with her love to other people. Mm-hmm. So we're going to take a look right now at a profile of Amy Grant, kind of a recap of her accolades and the magnitude of all of that, and followed by her signature video, which
oh, yeah.
is Amy at her finest.
Mm-hmm.
And it is?
Lead Me On.
That's right. Check it out on Victory Videos.
I'm reminded of a little boy whose mother carefully and lovingly packed a simple meal of bread and fish and sent him on a day's journey. And he's sitting in a big crowd of people, much more equipped to hear the speaker, much more equipped to experience the day. And yet there was a need for what he brought. And so a little boy gathers his courage and takes his meal forward to the master. Jesus prayed over 5 loaves and 2 fish. And what happened? A boy's simple gift fed a multitude of people. Well, when I was a kid, I learned to play the guitar and I started writing songs and didn't have a great voice, didn't have a lot of skill with my hands. But you know what? In my world, I had 5 loaves and 2 fish. And when I wound up in a music industry that was looking for songs for hope, sung from a sincere heart, I knew I had it. And all I did was gather my courage and walk forward and say, that's what I've got.
Oh, how the years go by. And oh, how the love brings tears to my eyes. All through the changes, the soul never dies. We fight, we laugh, we cry as the years go by.
Amy Grant has emerged from the gospel music field as a major force in pop music and a recognized force in today's culture. She has won 5 Grammy Awards, 17 Dove Awards, including 4 times Artist of the Year, and has received platinum certification on 7 albums. Release, Heart in Motion, has sold over 4 million copies, and in 1992, the first single from the album, Baby Baby, reached number 1 simultaneously in both R&R and Billboard magazine. Amy was nominated for 4 Grammys from that album, Song of the Year, Record of the Year, Pop Female Performance, and Album of the Year. The music world has watched her music and her life blossom through the years. Even with the extraordinary demands put on Amy's life from her successful music career, she still finds time to give to others. In 1992, she was named Young Tennessean of the Year by the Nashville Chamber of Commerce, and her service to the community continues through her participation as an alumni of the Leadership Music Program in Nashville. The Leadership Music Program encourages its members to invest their time and talent in efforts that will benefit the community. Amy also participates in the Make-A-Wish Foundation by donating her time to meet with children diagnosed with terminal diseases. And she is an active supporter of the American Cancer Society and Habitat for Humanity. In recognition of her many achievements, on May 1st, 1994, she was honored at St. John's University by the Benedictine Order with the prestigious Pax Christi Award, the Peace of Christ Award.
St. John's has chosen to honor singer Amy Grant, who becomes the 3rd woman and the 9th layperson to receive this award. And now, will you join me in welcoming to this place Miss Amy Grant?
I've watched the sun rise and set on the ocean, many oceans, but it reminds me of the power of God's creation, and nobody has to explain it to me. I inherited 3 nieces who, by the time they were almost in high school, had never seen the ocean. I couldn't believe it. We drove and parked in the parking lot on the opposite side of the highway. I said, close your eyes. You're not going to believe this. Close your eyes. my heart was pounding that I got to be the lucky one to make this introduction. And with eyes closed, they're climbing those stairs and walking across the top of that bridge. You can hear the highway under them, but it's nothing compared to the roar of that sea. And when they got to the top of the bridge, I said, "Open your eyes." And they saw that water and started laughing and screaming. Because you know what? The postcards don't do it justice. TV and surround sound, they don't come close. The next thing I knew, those girls were running down the other side of those steps, straight into the water, with their dinner clothes on and everything. I think the love of God is like the ocean. It's the greatest component of our world, even though we don't see it a lot of the time. What an honor for me to get to introduce so many people to such a grand thing. Thank you.
Cut it out! We're not supposed to have fun.
Cut it
out. And there's some more of the mighty Ohio. Boy, that water's cold, I'll
bet. That's right, I'll bet it is.
Do you think?
This time of year.
Moves fast. Well, welcome back to the show. That was just Amy Grant with Lead Me On. That was one of Amy's signature videos, one that showcased her. This was a really difficult subject for her to take on, and boy, she really did it well, didn't
That's
she?
That's right. She's recorded a lot of songs over the years and done a lot of videos, but this particular one really shows her maturity as an artist, LaVille.
Yeah, I think so, too.
She was able to step out and really make a good one. It's one of our favorites.
Yeah.
When it's one of those Dave's pick, LaVille's pick, and Harold's pick, too. One thing we try to do on this program whenever we can is to bring you new artists. And up next, our feature on a new artist, and this is a group called Imagine This. And they already have done a video already, which is just, imagine this.
Imagining this.
Which is just amazing when you think about how the Christian market has grown. They're brand new, new group, new song, and they're already doing a video.
That's cool.
So let's check it out.
It used to take a long time.
That's right.
Yeah.
Here's Revolution from Imagine This on Victory Videos.
In a revolution, singing. She was a little lady living on the other side, looking like a tweed in an ocean. She was a little fighter, freaking was a middle name, living like a sand to the snakes. Living on the other side, looking like a tweed in an ocean of pride. She was a little fighter, freaking was a middle name, living like a sand to the snakes in his clay.
missing something there.
This is New Guinea.
It's so powerful.
I don't see it.
I'm having an out-of-decade experience. I was walking and came upon a fountain which bore the sign, "Don't drink the water."
Do you
and
get
the beggar
this?
Carries a Isn't sign it fantastic? Saying, "I'm blind." What does this poem mean to me? It's like a collage of images.
Let's
and
face
sounds.
It, not every cultural activity appeals to everyone. So we're giving you something everyone likes, a choice. That's why 23,000 arts and humanities groups are inviting you to find something you can get excited about. Just call for a free brochure about what's going on in your community.
I think I'm getting into this.
They're tuning up.
The arts and humanities, there's something in it for you. There's a lot going on in your community. For a free brochure on how to get involved, call our toll-free number.
Like you under.
When Raymond was 6, I was afraid to take him to the playground because they were doing drugs. When he was 10, I couldn't let him play ball in the schoolyard because of the gangs. When he was 15, I wouldn't let him go to any dances because there could be a fight or a shooting. Now he's a man, and I realize he's never been a kid.
Give your children back their childhood. Do something now. Call 1-800-WE-PREVENT. Together, we will take a bite out of crime.
Welcome back to our Amy Grant special on Victor Videos. I'm Dave Dobbins.
And I'm Lavila Kraft.
And we hope you're enjoying our show so far. We've seen music from Brian Duncan, Greg Long, Margaret Becker.
Imagine that.
Imagine this. Amy Grant. Now we're going to talk about a lady whose career path is a lot like Amy Grant. Her name is...
Kathy Tricoli.
Kathy is a
Stole
great...
Stole it from you, didn't I?
That's right. You sure did. Ran out of my mouth. Here's a lady who has just really grown in her career. We're featuring her because we kind of see her going some of the same ways that Amy's going.
Yeah.
She has crossed over in a lot of the mainstream market.
Mm-hmm.
And her people are... promoting her much the same way.
Yes.
Kathy Tricoli has gone on to record some great songs. This one is just a real emotional. She likes to do love songs.
Oh, she's a ballad singer,
yeah,
for sure.
Yeah, she really likes those love songs.
Mm-hmm.
And this one is called Tell Me Where It Hurts.
Oh, gosh, that didn't get you, doesn't it?
That just kind of gets me right here.
Okay.
Check it out.
Watch.
That sad look in your eyes. Why are you crying? Tell me now, tell me now. Tell me why you're feeling this way. I hate to see you so down. Oh, baby, is it your heart? Ooh, breaking all in pieces. Making you cry, making you feel blue. Is there anything that I can do? Many things that I can do. Why don't you tell me where it hurts now, baby?
And welcome back to Victory Videos as we look at our profile on Miss Amy Grant. What do you like about Amy Grant, LaVilla?
I think she's really fun-spirited, and she's one of those kind of just, I don't know.
Boy, I'll tell you, we're going to have to write that one down for the books. Well,
Amy takes chances. Oh, that's true, too.
She's gone where no woman has gone before.
She's wholesome. That's the word I was looking for.
Yeah, that's
it. Wholesome.
That's right.
Isn't she? Mm-hmm. Down home on the farm kind of girl?
Just like LaVilla, right?
Oh. Wholesome.
But she's taken risks with her career that probably could have destroyed other people, but she's hung in there. But also, we told you at the beginning of the program, we're going to look at a different side of Amy Grant and this humanitarian aspect. Mm-hmm. She received an award for humanitarianism, and she works with the Habitat for Humanity organization.
As well as other little things that she does in the community.
Mm-hmm. And the concerts that she and her husband, Gary Chapman, are going to be doing this year, some of the proceeds will go towards building a house.
That's neat.
Houses for people who are underprivileged and may not have a home.
Right. Maybe she's going to be throwing a hammer with old Jimmy Baby.
But you know, yeah.
Jimmy Carter? He does that.
Actually, yeah. She really wanted
him to. We wanted him
to
put that in there.
Okay. We're talking about Amy Grant, her house of love, and really the thing I wanted to say here, LaVilla, is that her marriage, I'm sure like everybody else's marriage with career demands,
right,
a lot of highs and lows,
mm-hmm,
but without the love of God in there to hold it together, I'm sure it wouldn't have been as strong as
right.
it is.
So it's a good
stick
example.
In there and watch this profile on Amy Grant, followed by her first video from Heart in Motion, which is called Baby.
See ya.
The more how the years go by, and oh how the love brings tears to my eyes. All through the changes, the soul never dies. We fight, we laugh, we cry as the years go by.
Although Amy's a leader in the community and a busy recording artist, more importantly, she's the devoted mother of three children and the dedicated wife of singer-songwriter Gary Chapman. Recently, she invited us to her home to discuss her latest Word A&M recording, House of Love. Amy, I have to ask you, every time you do a new record, you seem to have a new baby. Now, did you and Gary plan it this way, and are there any surprises coming with this new record?
Not that I know of. It's just been a wonderful coincidence. I think we get in the creative mood, and it just affects all areas of life.
Now, were you able to do most of this album at home?
I was. Not necessarily in my home, but I did the entire record, well, most of it, in Franklin, Tennessee. Time at home is very precious, and the farm is a very peaceful place to be.
I understand that you've been working very hard with a variety of organizations that provide a great deal of help and comfort. And I wonder what compelled you to work with organizations that help with terminally ill children, cancer patients, homeless people.
My dad treats cancer patients. And so I've seen him for a lifetime carry the weight of caring for dying people. I think that instilled in me as a very young child that was just a part of life, being there for somebody in need.
This work sounds like it brings you a lot of special joy in your life. And I know that you just received a very special award for your achievements, the Peace of Christ Award. How did you react to finding out that you had gotten that?
Well, honestly, my first response was, okay, I'm trading in my crown in heaven to be honored with the Peace of Christ Award. The celebration around the Pax Christi Award was maybe the highlight of my musical experience. Yes, I was the recipient, but the whole point of the award is thousands of people coming together saying, this is what we celebrate. This is what makes life on this earth really mean something. You sort of look around and say, this is my family, and we still believe in the same things.
Amy, you're known for reaching out to those around you, and your albums have wound up in homes all around the world. Let's talk about the new album.
Well, choosing an album title is an interesting process. The House of Love was a real strong title idea. It's not a real heavy song, but it was a blast to do. I'm singing
with Vince Gill, who's a neighbor and a good friend.
Another song on the album is Say You'll Be Mine.
The song just celebrates that euphoric kind of front end of being in love.
Oh, sure, I would like to be in love forever.
For a lifetime.
Forever.
Always.
And you know, that's a pretty tough emotion to maintain throughout a lifetime.
Absolutely, it is.
It is. But it's fun to celebrate when it's there.
I'd do anything it takes to keep my marriage together.
I'm willing to give.
We'll take everything, all of you.
Whatever it takes.
Whatever it takes, baby.
Thank you.
time as a junior achievement elementary school volunteer can be a little scary. Can you get kids that young to think about their futures? Call us about volunteering, and you'll see. We'll supply you with training for this new program, and the kids will supply plenty of motivation.
The air dances with the waters, which brings the rain that feeds the land, that is home to the animals. All life dances together.
In a world so connected, choosing one environmental cause can be hard. EarthShare is 40 environmental charities working together. You and your company can help by calling 1-800-MY-SHARE.
All life lives, or doesn't, together.
Here's one time it doesn't matter who your neighbor is. Here's the other. Life's too short. Stop the hate.
And we are back.
Welcome back.
And that is...
That's cool.
That is
baby,
the video.
Baby, baby. Isn't that one of those songs that just sticks with you all
That's
day?
Good,
you know
it?
Even just by mentioning the title.
A song really like that was originally written about her little kid.
Yeah, it's cute.
The little baby baby.
Yeah, the baby baby.
What can we say about Amy Grant that hasn't been said before? She's big, she's huge. She's doing things that are paving the way for many in the music business, but she's also setting examples as a Christian woman,
yes,
as a businesswoman also, that are setting standards for people to look to her. I know she's not perfect, but she also is trying to listen to God and do the things that He has instructed her to do.
Mm-hmm.
And she's leading the way. She literally is leading.
Leading.
That's right.
Yep.
So, she's back. She's got a new project, and it's called...
And it's called...
The House...
The House of Love.
House of Love.
House of Love.
And there's a song on this album with Vince Gill, and lots of different things. She's done some releases on television earlier this year with the Children of the World. But what we're going to see now is a profile on Amy also.
Yeah.
And her new song.
Her new song.
Which is called...
Which is called...
Right here, LaVilla. Lucky one.
You knew that, we've heard that one, yeah.
This is all, I mean, you know, you walk into most of your record stores and it's there. So she's going places that no woman has gone before. Here's Amy Grant with Lucky One on Victory Videos, where no man or woman has gone before.
It seems like kids of all ages like to come to your concerts. Families, moms, dads, kids, they all enjoy your music.
You know, my favorite scenario is to be on stage and to look out and see this youth group over here. I start a song and they're reacting. They're not reacting to me, they're reacting to their memory of that song, the things that made that song special to them. I know that there are kids that come to the concerts that don't have any kind of a church background. And many times the audience has as great effect on those kids as I do. Because suddenly they're in an environment where they're not getting stampeded and they feel the fellowship.
Now, what are your plans to include Habitat for Humanity in the House of Love tour?
I'm so glad you asked this question. I got involved with Habitat for Humanity about 6 years ago. It only makes sense with this album being called House of Love. And we're going to be doing the House of Love tour. Our plan right now is that in every city in which we hold a concert, we'll take part of the ticket proceeds and hopefully build a house in every town for somebody who's been living in substandard housing. And I love the fact of being able to stand on stage saying, tonight you didn't just come to have fun, but you also, with the purchase of your ticket, have given something to a family. I can write sad songs with the best of them, but what I really want when I put on music is to be reminded of the good things. What goes around and around and around in your head and in your mind eventually finds root in your heart. And that makes me, it drives me to write things that that I want to be incorporated into my life.
Dave, it's been fun today, hasn't it?
It sure has. The light is fading down behind us
right,
as the sun is setting.
Dark.
That's right. And we're going to say goodbye But before we do, there's Amy Grant in our special profile in Victor Videos, a woman who's grown into the 90s as she grows into the next century.
Right.
You're going to see a lot of Amy Grant. What
setting
final words
examples,
do you have?
Setting those examples, isn't it? Don't hide your light under a bushel.
That's right. And if you may be in a place in your life where you want to reach out and sing with your music, don't hide it.
Mm-hmm.
Get to somebody, call us, we'll help you. Share your music, share your light with somebody today. Until next time, it's Dave Dobbins.
And LaVie LaCraft.
Saying, remember to love somebody with the love of Jesus. Bye-bye.
Bye.
It's getting dark. I'm getting scared.